Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, we're going to talk about the different join types in SQL. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. So in my first video on t-sql, I talked about writing your first SQL statement, and I introduced you to the inner join. In this video, we're going to revisit the inner join, but we're also going to talk about the left and the right outer join and the full outer join. We're not going to talk about cross apply because it's a little beyond the scope, and it only becomes significant when you use table value functions, which we haven't talked about. But the thing that you should remember is that if you do a cross apply with some type of equality or even inequality, you will be creating a Cartesian product, which will return a lot of data. So try to avoid them. All right. So you guys know how I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. First, we're going to start with the inner join. It's going to return all the rows from my internet sales and my product sales where product key is equal. So it's only going to return the rows that satisfy that equality. And it's a pretty simple statement, right? Select star. Remember, we can specify columns. We can use the alias to get individual columns from that particular table. We can do lots of different things. The outer join is a little different. When I write a query, the very first table that appears in that query is the one that's on the left. And the next one that appears is on the right. And so you can see I have a left join here. There is an optional keyword outer that you can specify. So I can do left join or I can do left outer join. In the case that my internet sales is my left table, it's going to return all the rows in internet sales, whether or not, in this case, a matching product key exists in the product table. And so in this particular query, I'm looking for all my sales that contain a product key that doesn't exist in my product table. And so if I run this query, it's going to return a particular result set. And you may notice that I've added a where clause here. And this where clause is specifically looking for any instance across these rows where the product key doesn't exist in the product table. It'll limit the result set. So if I ran this query without the where clause, it'll return all the rows where the product keys match and then all the rows in the internet sales where they don't match. So if we run this query, what you'll see is a whole bunch of rows. And if I scroll to the right, you'll see all the columns from that product table, they're null. If we scroll back over to where they start and go to the top, you'll see where all of the columns from the product table, they're completely null. Now, what I could do is, I'm gonna introduce you to a new keyword called distinct, and it does exactly what it says. It's gonna give me a distinct list of the product keys from my sales table. So I'm gonna find all of the product keys that don't exist in my product table, but they are currently used in the sales table. So let's go ahead and run this, and we'll see that there's a single product key. Now, to validate this, what I could do is I'm going to add a new code cell to my notebook, and I'm going to say select star from DBO product where product key equals 222. Now I'm going to check. Right now, my left outer join is saying, hey, there's one product key that's being used in the sales table that's not in my product table. If I run this, in fact, that product key doesn't exist. And this is a good use of the left outer join. I'm trying to check my data validity. And unfortunately, in your SQL Server database, you can create relationships across your tables that enforce integrity. In Synapse, you can't. You would do it as part of your ETL process. Anyway, I found a product that doesn't exist, so I need to contact my DBA or whoever owns this particular database and tell them, hey, you need to insert product 222 into the product table. Okay. The right is very similar. In this case, what I'm trying to do is find any product that don't have sales. So remember I said internet sales is on the left because it's the first table that appears in the query, and product is on the right. It's the second one. So I'm saying, give me all the products, whether or not they've sold. And then I'm saying where the product key in the sales table is null, meaning that the product in the product table doesn't exist. Now you'll notice if you go back up to where I did the left outer join, I'm referencing the product key because I'm saying, give me all the sales where the product key in the product table is null, meaning that it doesn't exist in the product table. And I'm doing the exact same thing for my right outer join. I'm saying, give me all of the products, whether or not they correspond to a row in the internet sales table. And so let's go ahead and run this. And what you're going to see is lots of nulls on my sales column tables. And if I go to the right, you see all the values for the columns in the product table. Now what I can do is distinct, like I did earlier, of all the p.product keys and p.english product name. And so if I run this, it'll give me a distinct list of all the product keys and product names that haven't sold, that don't exist in my internet sales table. So you can see there's lots of products. And I can do the same type of validation. I can say select star from internet sales for product key is one, and it won't return any rows. The last one I want to talk about is the full outer join. Remember in the initial SQL video, I said a join is like a Venn diagram. And so the inner join, you have those two circles and it's just a little intersection. That's the rows that's going to return. In a left outer join, it's going to return the intersection, but also all the rows in the left circle. And then the right is the exact same thing. It'll return the intersection and all the rows in the right table. Well, full outer join is going to return the intersection and all the rows in the left table and all the rows in the right table. Let me show you what I'm talking about. If I run this query right here, it's going to return all the rows where this equals, and then it's going to return all the rows where they don't equal, where there's no corresponding product in the product table. So all the internet sales, and then it's going to return all the products that don't have sales. So it's just a collection of all of them. I know we haven't talked about aggregations, but you can do different types of aggregations, and I'll do a video and show you a very interesting use case for these aggregations. So I'm just going to count. I can put a column here, but I'm just going to say count all of them. So I'm going to run this, and so I'll get a result set of 581,000 rows. I can validate this. Remember what I said, the full outer join returns the inner join where all the columns are equal. And then for my right outer joins, it's going to return all the products that don't have sales and all the sales that correspond to products that don't exist in the product table. And I know we haven't talked about subqueries, and I'm going to do a video on subqueries and talk about those at length, but watch this. I'm counting all the rows and then I'm going to sum those totals, and it should equal to my full outer join. Let's go ahead and run this. 581,000 rows. The full outer join returns all the data from all the tables in all the rows based on that equality, whether or not it equals or doesn't equal. All right, what do you guys think? Do you want more on joins? Do we want to, let's talk about some aggregations and some groupings. I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.